that could not have been the worst time to start an LP. Right as I'm saying my first word, the phone rings. And I'm just trying to speed through the goddamn conversation with the family as fast as possible. Just like, all right, yes, yes, no, yes, no. I plead the fifth. Yes, no, bye. Oh, God. So much needless stuff to be said. Yes, I know you love me. God damn it. No, I'm not like that typically, but you get the idea. You have something planned. It's like, hello, I'm trying to do something here, but I can't tell you what it is. I'm trying to do something. Ugh. Anyway, hey everybody, it's 40 Warrior, and welcome to Ratchet and Clank Up Your Arsenal. It's one of the PS2 versions of one of the PS2 games of the series. Unfortunately, I have a lot of interest in the series, but I never got a PS3 or a PS4. So, that kind of shut the door on me really quick. Most unfortunate. I wanted to do a Ratchet and Clank LP. I had one the works before, but things came up. So, that shot it down very quick. So, anyway, let's get started on this. Yeah, the last time I picked this game up. That must bode well. Last time I picked this game up was 2.5 years ago. I'm so fucked. Anyway, let's get started. You guys don't need to hear me just rambling on and on and on like something.
My Blargian snaggle beast devours your mutant swamp fly. Oh yeah, I bet you didn't see that one coming.
Hey, what are you doing?
Check and mate.
What? That's cheating!
On the contrary, the rules clearly state that the Blargian snagglebeast has an allergic reaction to swamp flies that last 2 turns.
Ooh,
it is on again.
Your luck is extraordinary, sir. But do you lose as gracefully as you win?
I would not know, Maximilian. I never lose.
There is a first time for everything.
Agent Clank! Missed! So much for the famous secret agent!
Shocking. Bring the car around, Jeeves. And mind the ejector seat this time.
Stay tuned for more Secret Agent Clank.
And they say the house always wins. Ha ha ha.
That was terrific.
Yeah, great. Change the channel.
But the man said to stay tuned.
We continue our live coverage from Velden. Just hours ago, the planet was attacked without warning by a terrifying alien race known as the Tyhrranoids. Officials believe that an evil robotic supervillain known as Dr. Nefarious is the mastermind behind the Tyhrranoid attack. As you can see, the Galactic Rangers are putting up a valiant fight, but they are no match for these tentacle-eyed terrors. Indeed, this backwater planet may be completely destroyed in a matter of hours. Darla Gratch, Channel 64 News.
We're going home. But Velden is in the Solana galaxy. Oh no, not the gravimetric warp drive. The untested gravimetric warp drive? The one you built from Blargian scrap metal?
Coming?
We are doomed.
You were saying?
I stand corrected.
I just hope we're not too late.
So why do they call them Tyhrranoids? My money is, they are aliens who happen to be tyrannical. That's a Tyhrranoid. Just a guess. I mean, I don't know. Ratchet and Clank series has been known for puns and stuff, but that wouldn't be considered a pun, now would it? But they probably have a simplistic sense of humor in this case. Anyway, progress is saving. This is not important. Let's go.
Greetings, client 91.
Oh, yes, I forgot. There's one thing I need to do. You play enough games, you learn that you want first person and you don't want inverted shit. That you know. You want third person, dingbat. Actually, I want Lockstrafe, yeah. And no inverted! Inverted's the bane of my existence.
And welcome back to the Solana Galaxy.
Yeah, when you play too many Mass Effect type games and you play a bunch of FPSs where you have the same sort of camera going.
These must be the Galactic Rangers.
Yeah.
Hey, look! It's a new sergeant!
Huh?
Hey, Sarge, you can have my gun. There's too many of them! We're all gonna die!
Yep, the Galactic Rangers are bitches. And we got the Shot Blaster, our first weapon. It is basically a shotgun. A shotgun that I remember was in the, one of the game trailers for this. And the guy tested it. He basically sent someone through the, pretty much through the moon. Create a new crater.
Am I glad to see you, Sarge? We're pinned down by that enemy vehicle. Somebody's gotta take it out.
Let me guess. That somebody is me.
We got a volunteer. Here, Sarge, take this. We'll cover you. From back there!
That's not really covering anything, Beth, but whatever.
I'm using the nitro launcher.
Oh, thanks. And, yep, the nitro launcher, basically a grenade launcher. It just sounds cooler to say nitro. But I do like some of the weapon names, though. Nitro launcher's a lot more badass than a grenade launcher. Just like it's nice to say shot blaster instead of shotgun. I would definitely love to have a thing like that. So, anyway. Yeah, this thing's freaking loud in my computer. Can't hear myself think, let alone talk. That's not a good thing ever. Let's go. So the same controls as before, you just basically swipe at things with a wrench, with the square, and so on and so forth. Nothing really to talk about there. I had something for this, but I completely forgot what it was, if you can't tell. But then again, the way this part started, it doesn't really matter at this point. I don't know how he hit me there. How do you even know he's behind me? Or I was behind him? How come nobody is no match for the Nitro Launcher? I love how early on these things are so OP, and then you get to later on, and it's like, wow, these things holy effing suck. It's like they go by tiers and then some. Did I bet you? Haha. So, it's my first LP recording in kind of a while, actually. But
your maximum nano.
Nice thing about it is I'm actually in a better state of mind than I was, say. About a month ago. Because I was going through the stress of taxis and everything like that, which is pretty bad in itself. And then I got the news that my friend passed away, just suddenly. She was 8 days older, so she was 27. That's too young for somebody to go, especially somebody you know. That's the first time I've ever been to a funeral wake. Not the first time I've been to a wake, but the first time I've been to a funeral. Things like that. Kind of keeps life in perspective. Makes you appreciate the friends you have, in addition to how quickly you can lose everything. You kind of just want to live life to the fullest, which is why I'm LPing right now, right? Because this is totally living life to the fullest. Like, I'm living the American dream right now. American dream. If the American dream is LPing, then God fucking damn it. We are doomed. I knocked LPing a lot. Let's face it, it's a degree of fun. Well, the degree of
fallen back to a base in F sector.
Art too.
We have orders to go in and take him out. F sector? No way. Game over, man. We're all gonna end up as scrap metal.
Get back in there, trooper. We've got a planet to save.
Sir, yes, sir.
How did Ratchet just suddenly become a sergeant? How did everybody start to know about it? Anyway, I kind of consider it like a sort of art. Maybe I'm just saying this because I'm not very artistically inclined. I was joking with people that basically I was never good at art. I can draw a mean stick figure, but that's about the extent of it for me. So don't ever take artistic advice from me. If I tell you to use paint, use pastel. If I tell you to use pastel, use pencil. If I tell you to use black and white, go crazy with the paint. Be a fucking Picasso. And so on and so forth. Oh, now the Glide Rangers get a set.
Watch out! They're coming out of the rubble!
Yeah, I'm awful. I was terrible at Legos and things like that nature. I guess you read books and magazines as a kid. And my favorite thing to play with, that was like four or whatever, was probably a calculator. I shit you not. Always been interested by numbers.
Waste those Tyhrranoids!
But, I mean, to an extent. You get to like fucking algebra, I mean, not too many people like algebra, let's just say that. And you get advanced stats, things of that nature. Yeah. That's a little too far. I'm in decent place right now where I can just do basic, put complex addition, subtraction, division, multiplication. That's good enough for me. Why? Because I don't want to apply myself to anything more. It doesn't make me lazy, it makes me a realist. It makes me realize the practicality of things, which is a very important thing to learn. Or so I tell myself to justify my existence. Okay, I'm not in that sort of a state of mind, but I'm just gonna drop the topic completely. I'm shooting myself in the foot. Very easy drop ship, as you can see. Well, this whole Velden thing is super easy as it is.
Sir, we have a transmission from the president!
How are things on the front line, soldier? Is that secret agent Clank?
Greetings, sir. We are here to help.
Well, this is an honor, and I see you brought your chauffeur along.
What? No. Hold on a second, sir.
Agent Clank, we must stop Dr. Nefarious. As you may know, only one man has ever faced him and survived. I've just received a top secret report on that man's whereabouts. Here, take a look.
On tonight's episode of Nature's Mysteries, we examine the Florana tree beast. Deep in the dense growth of Florana's Jambu forest lives a mysterious creature. Or maybe he doesn't. It's one of Nature's Mysteries.
I've seen him run right through our camping site. He was buck naked, screaming and holding a banana. Or maybe it weren't a banana. It could be.
One of Nature's Mysteries. Legend tells that this mysterious creature is actually one of the greatest superheroes who ever lived. Shamed by his recent past, he is now. One of Nature's Mysteries. Tune in and find out the answers.
We need you to find this man. The fate of the galaxy may depend on it.
Are you sure this is the guy you're looking for, Mr. President? Yeah, he seems like kind of a, you know, wacko.
You may be right, but he's the best chance we've got. I know you boys won't let me down.
You can count on us, sir.
He seems like one of Nature's Mysteries! Yeah, whatever. The president sounds a little too much like Bill Clinton for me. I have to make that parallel. Granted, I can't do a Bill Clinton voice, so I have a friend that can, but this is a little close for me, for my liking. So yeah, that guy's basically Bill Clinton to me. And now I end up in Florida because I need to find one of nature's mysteries! Whatever it may be. And here's our first vendor, I'm just going to load up really quick. N60 Storm, decent weapon for, you know, tier 1, I guess you could say. Or I can just get a melee weapon that'll bitch slap everything. But I have it basically close to a melee weapon and a shotgun, so it's like in Halo. You don't use the shotgun and the energy sword at the same exact time. You just don't. It doesn't end well in multiplayer, ever. Especially when you meet somebody who has a BR in their hands. So with that in mind, let's venture forth. I said let's venture forth. Don't fall in the water. It doesn't end well. Luckily, the shock blaster loads up but don't kill us so quick. Presumably because it's such a weak sauce weapon.
Your controller can be configured with...
Yep, I know. Unimportant. I know my shit. That's what matters. So in this area, it's basically tribal. As you can tell by the music, and by the fact the robots are saying Ooga Booga. That might be racist. I don't know. I just like make fun of that because people go a little too far with it all the freaking time. Some things are, and some things aren't. But just because some things are, you know, on the gray, in the shades of gray, does not make it racist. I'm just gonna say that right now. So I don't have as liberal a definition of it as other people do. I don't know why I got on that topic, but let's just leave it away. Anyway, jackpot crate means money, money, money. For as long as it goes. So I'm embarrassed state of, I was mentioning embarrassed state of mind, that's because I was, had a school reunion last weekend of May. 5-year reunion. Get down. Get down, boy. Go ahead, get down. This is the first time I saw my friends since the funeral. And, well, you don't want to meet anybody under those circumstances. And first level up! Woo! Doesn't mean shit.
Weapons upgrade automatically when they're used.
Now it has a charge function.
Hold circle to charge up the shock blaster for a more powerful attack.
More concentrated, uses two ammo or whatever, or maybe one, I don't know. But it's a lot better now than it was before. That's all that matters. So, don't fall in the water, it's death. You'll be eaten by a giant piranha. A giant alien piranha.
To perform a high jump, hold
don't care, I have the double jump, bitch.
X.
I am a rebel. I am not impressed by your advice. My advice to you would be to shut up. My advice to me would be to shut up, too.
Run, then press R2 and X at the same time.
Usroda! Usroda! Dovahkiin. Dragonborn! Fusroda! Oh. More Fusroda dying. That worked out well. Also, Ratchet doesn't climb ladders.
You can climb a ladder,
especially ladders that look like cones.
And press
he jumps
X until you reach the top.
Get back. Nice knowing you, bitches. So we had the reunion. It was basically a weekend on campus, so there was a lot of drinking going on. There was a barbecue too, which is nice. Nothing really majorly absurd came out of it. I mean, I was pretty much drunk all of Saturday. So I just chilling. Basically in that drunk state where you never got effed up and you never were sober. It's a pretty happy place to be. You know, if you still have the mind of a college student. Hold on a sec. Gotta crack open one. I have this bottle opener that is actually like a hollowed out sniper rifle bullet. It's really sick. Really effective, too. One shot, one kill. So that was going on and not cold enough. Shit. Ah. Time to get the N60 Storm. It's basically just a semi-assault rifle or whatever. But before we go anywhere, you want to go below yourself. Below me. Yeah, below me, get it?
Ha ha ha! Put down your straw, Chebec, and shug it! Shug it long and shug it hard!
I gotta come up with this shit. I don't know why that's the thing stuck in my mind. So, anyway, the most absurd thing that happened. Me and a friend were really effed up on Friday night, so we decided. We were looking to do some drink games outside, so we tried to bring a table outside. We were effed up when this was happening, and we took a table from outside of campus at 1 in the morning, from outside of the dorm, inside the dorm, to outside of the dorm. Campus police was curiously cool with it. Probably because they're more laid back than they were when I was there. That's not bias. That's actually true.
Inferno mode.
That's basically what Inferno mode is. It's like having a Starman and wrenches. Seriously, you don't take damage. It's awesome. And as we took it outside to the front of the building, then the unfortunate incident occurred. The sprinkler system came on, so the table got soggy. We got freaking soaked. It was not fun. We just basically said screw it. We brought the table back inside. It was completely waterlogged, obviously. Ooh, got me good there. I'm not gonna take that just yet. I'm going the other way. There's still some goodies here. I know where a lot of the goodies are in this game, just not all of them, so don't expect 100% run of any kind. Now that we got that out of the way. It's a little secret here, and it'll get you a trophy. They're basically for pride, nothing more, nothing less. Also, Ratchet's not doing his animation. He's largely unimpressed with himself. He's unimpressed with the Ratchet trophy. Yes, enemies do have friendly fire, in which case they'll actually hurt each other instead of you. It's awesome when it happens. Although it doesn't give your weapons any credit, as far as I know. All in all, it was a good weekend, though. I thoroughly enjoyed it. They just chilled at a friend's house for a little bit of Sunday, then I drove back. And when I drove back, I was flipping through the radio stations. I must have heard Tove Lo's songs like 15 times from the drive, and it's a 2.5 hour drive. So yeah, Tove Lo basically took up a third of my trip.
We have company.
Involuntarily, I might add.
Behind you.
Where?
Behind you.
Very funny. You having a good time?
You trespass on sacred ground. Now you walk path of death.
But, sir.
Path of death.
One of nature's mysteries. Anyway, now here we go to the path of death. This is a skill point if you guys should do this completely unscathed. If you do it completely unscathed, well, what's the skill point give you? Extra skins. It's a cool touch. And hey, I'm going to try for it. I will actively try for it, but if I don't get it, I'm not going to friggin' rage quit and whatever, so. Basically, don't get hit at all. That's the object of the path of death. And I passed that little pit. There's a couple fire traps, and other than that, it's largely unimpressive, you know, for a path of death, especially considering I have 13 hit points. And once we get here, stop, turn. Path of Death has Titanium Bolt! Hey, Ratchet's showing the animation this time. Whew. So that's the first Titanium Bolt. Or is it the second? I forget. I know some. The launch up in this game, kind of like in Donkey Kong 64. No point to having it. Because you have other things that function just as well, if not better. And same with Spyro the Dragon 2 and 3. Where the charge jump is just basically OP. This is where I'll usually get hit. Hey. Mad skills, yo! Mad skills! Oh, this part's not exactly fun. Right now, the N60 Storm Brute, that without a doubt is my best weapon. So close. So close. There you go. First skill point. Boom. LP curse, huh? Yeah. Shoot to that, baby. Yeah, I saw Happy Gilmore recently.
Okay. We walked your path of death. Now, tell us what you know about Dr. Nefarious.
Who? Huh?
Dr. Nefarious. They say you're the only man to ever beat him.
Who? Huh?
Jeez. This guy's even dumber than...
Captain Quark?
Yeah. Captain Quark. That's it.
Captain Quark is one of nature's mysteries.
He's coming for a long time.
Oh god, there's no mysterious about this guy. This guy's a dipshit. Anyway, he is supremely easy. Because his pattern is so freaking easy to deal with. This is his pattern. I'm just showing it off. Then he gets pissed off and says, you know what? Minions, do your duty. And then once that's done, you just say shut up to the bitch again and you start this whole thing all over again. Oop! Oh, it looks like you got a double shut off there. No, you don't, bitch. I own you. I own you, B. I own you! And because of the boss fight, you got a ton of experience for your weapon. So make sure you use your weapon, choose your weapon wisely.
Quark has completely lost his mind. Now what?
Just keep the mask on. He thinks you are his new leader.
Great.
Incoming call.
This is Captain Sasha of the Starship Phoenix. The President has asked me to assist you.
Hi.
I see you have located Captain Quark.
Yeah, we got him, but, well, he thinks he's a monkey.
Of course. Bring him to the Phoenix and we'll see what we can do. Sasha out.
And that's Florana. Pretty simple. Once that's done, well, I'm going to stop the part as soon as I land on the freaking starship. And I guess I'll see you next time. 40 Warriors signing off.
Look at that, Clank. This ship is amazing.
Welcome aboard the Phoenix, gentlemen.
Whoa.
Impressive, isn't she? The Phoenix is the pride of the Galactic Fleet. She's equipped with the latest technology. Holodeck training suite, auto vendors for armor and weapons, virtual firing range, starfighter upgrade system, even a Gadgetron VG-9000 game system.
A VG-9000?
Of course. With a Mavix Fireball Pro controller, VR headset, and a zero-G dance pad attachment.
Will you marry me?
Well, you've obviously had an exhausting trip. Why don't you stop by your quarters? We prepared a custom living area for Quark, so he won't get in your way. Come meet me on the bridge when you're ready.